Hello, this is Dr. Grande. Welcome to my video on conducting a multiple regression using Microsoft Excel. I have fictitious data loaded into an Excel sheet, and I have two predictor variables, GPA and practice exam, and one outcome variable, comprehensive exam. So if we wanted to try to predict the comprehensive exam score using GPA and practice exam, we'd want to perform a multiple regression. A multiple regression is used when you have two or more predictor variables and one outcome variable. If we only had one predictor variable, for example, just the practice exam, and we wanted to use the practice exam score to predict the comprehensive exam score, that would be a simple linear regression. However, in this case, this fits a multiple regression because we have two predictors that we want to use. So let's get started calculating the multiple regression. I'm going to go to the data ribbon up top here, and all the way to the right there is a menu item, data analysis tools. Now if you don't have this menu item available in the data ribbon, just go to file and then options, and this Excel options dialog will appear. And you want to move down to add-ins, and you can see by default it's set to Excel add-ins. Just click go here, and you want to make sure analysis tool pack is checked off. And as you can see, in the case of this instance of Excel, I do have it checked off, so I'm just going to click cancel. Then I'm going to move up to the data analysis menu item and click that, and you can see there are several analysis tools available in the data analysis dialog. Regression is already selected here, and I'm going to stay with that and click OK. And then we have the regression dialog. The first item would be the input Y range, and that's going to be the dependent variable or the outcome variable. So I'm going to select that. I'm going to select C1 all the way through C51. So I have 50 values and I have the label comprehensive exam, all selected in that range. Then the input X range, this represents the predictor variables, and all the predictor variables are selected for this range. So I'm going to start with A1 and move down through B51. So both the GPA and practice exam scores all contained within this range. Again, I've included the first row for input X range and for input Y range, so I want to make sure I check labels here. I'm also going to add a confidence level and leave it set at the default 95%. For output options, I'm going to select output range and then select cell E4. This will represent the top left corner of the output that's displayed. And then under residuals, I'm going to select just the residuals option. There's also standardized residuals available and residual plots and line fit plots available. Under normal probability, I'm not going to check the normal probability plots. At this point, I'm ready to conduct the multiple regression, so I'm going to click OK. And you can see it starts with summary output, and you have regression statistics in this first table. The multiple R is 0.7. R square is 0.5. So this tells us that 50% of the variance in the outcome variable can be attributed to the predictor variables. So 50% of the variance in the comprehensive exam scores can be attributed to the grade point average and practice exam scores. Then we have an adjusted R-square, the standard error, and the number of observations, in this case 50. Looking at the output for the ANOVA table, of the most interest would be the probability value. In this case, it is less than 0.05, so it's statistically significant. And then we have down here in the bottom left the intercept. This is the y-intercept, and the coefficient here for that is 11. And then the slope for the GPA and the slope for the practice exam. So for the GPA, the slope is 9.6, and the practice exam, the slope is 0.3. For the y-intercept, the GPA, and the practice exam, we also have the standard error, the t-statistic, the p-value, and the lower and upper 95% confidence interval. Moving down the output, we have the observation number and the associated predicted comprehensive exam score, as well as the residuals. So if we look at observation 1, for example, we can see the predicted comprehensive exam score is 38.8, and the residual is -8.8. The way this is calculated is we take the comprehensive exam score, the actual score, and we subtract the score predicted using the estimated regression equation, in this case 38.8, and that gives us the residual of -8.8. And it's the same way for all of the observations. So if I select all of the predicted comprehensive exam scores and I copy them, let me control C, and move up here next to the comprehensive exam scores. I'm just going to hit control V and paste the predicted values. And I'll add an extra column to make this easier to see. Moving over here to the right of the multiple R value, put in equal sign and then CORREL, correlation. You can see the two arguments are array 1 and array 2. For array 1, I'm going to select the actual scores, then a comma, and then for array 2, the predicted scores, and click enter, and you can see it's the same value as the multiple R here returned in regression statistics. This value is the R value, the correlation between the actual comprehensive exam scores and the predicted comprehensive exam scores. If we square this value, which would be equal sign, and I'll select this value and the shift 6, which is the caret, and then 2, so 0.7 squared, we have the R-square value. So what if we want to use the estimated regression equation to predict outcomes on the comprehensive exam that aren't listed here, like combinations that aren't here? For example, we have 3.3 and a GPA 3.3 and a practice exam of 41. The actual comprehensive exam score is 62, the predicted 55.5. What if we had a GPA of 3.2 and a practice exam of 42? What would be the predicted score in that instance? Well, to calculate that, we use the estimated regression equation, which I'll build over here in cell H2. But first, I'll put the values that we want to predict for. 3.2 for the GPA and 42 for the practice exam. So if we had a grade point average observed of 3.2 and an observed practice exam of 42, now we want the predicted value using the estimated regression equation. So this will follow the format y equals mx plus b, except we'll have two predictor variables in this case. So it'll be equal sign, and then the slope for GPA, which is down here under coefficients, it's 9.6. Shift 8 for asterisk, so the slope for GPA times the observation for GPA, plus the slope for the practice exam times the practice exam score, 42, and then we'll add the y-intercept. So we have a predicted score of 54.9. So we can use this estimated regression equation for any combination of GPA and practice exam. So just to show you here, if we go back and use the values we had 3.3 and 41, so these are actual values we have in the data set, and we have the predicted value for that. If I plug these in, 3.3 for GPA and 41 for practice exam, it gives me the same value here, 55.58, and that matches the value that was returned by Excel. I hope you found this video on conducting a multiple regression in Excel to be useful. As always, if you have any questions or concerns, feel free to contact me, and I'll be happy to assist you.